Okay, so when it comes to all of the in-game event themes that we see in Pokemon Go, it's actually the Team Go Rocket themed events that ends up being a pleasant surprise. And of course, this particular event is no different. There's quite a lot to look forward to, and there's going to be a huge shakeup to some of the current Team Go Rocket gameplay that we have in the game. And there's a lot that we have to discuss, and there's a lot that we have to talk about when it comes to this event. I really think that if you are fully aware with what's going to be added into the game through this event, you're going to utilize it to its fullest potential, and you're not going to miss out on some really good shadow Pokemon. But unfortunately, this event is not a perfect event. Unfortunately, Niantic did make a huge misstep when it comes to this event, and I really think this could potentially be a huge missed opportunity, and I'm going to be talking about that as well. So yeah, let's roll the intro and get right into it. And how's it going, everyone? It's me, it's Count here with a brand new Pokemon Go video. Today I'm going to be talking about the Team Go Rocket celebration event that we have underway. This is a brand new Team Go Rocket themed event. It's kicking off 2021 with some new shadow Pokemon and some new eggs. So there's just a lot to talk about in this video, so let's just get right into it. First and foremost, this event is going to introduce brand new shadow Pokemon. We're going to see Shadow Swinub, Shadow Nosepass, Shadow Aggron, Shadow Lillipup, Shadow Anorith, and Shadow Sfeel added to the Team Go Rocket Battle Pool. Now, out of all of these new shadow Pokemon, there is one clear standout, and that is of course going to be Shadow Swinub. Swinub, of course, evolves into Mamoswine, which is already one of the top tier ice type attackers, so this Pokemon is definitely a new shadow that a lot of players are going to look for. Not only is Mamoswine a very powerful Pokemon for raid battles, but it's also a very powerful pick for the Master League in Pokemon Go's Go Battle League. So there's a lot of implications here for some very interesting gameplay. Expect to see a lot of Shadow Mamoswine in the Master League as well as in raid battles, because this Pokemon is definitely going to be extremely powerful. If there is any particular new shadow that you should target with this new shakeup, it's definitely going to be Swinub. But it's not just regular Team Go Rocket grunts that got a shakeup. We're also going to be seeing new shadow Pokemon with the Team Go Rocket leaders. When you go up against Arlo, you have the chance at getting a Shadow Beldum, and this of course can become shiny. If you're going up against Cliff, you could get a Shadow Aerodactyl, and then of course that shiny form is going to be available as well. And then when you go up against Sierra, you're going to get a Shadow Carvana. Now out of these three, it's super exciting at the thought of getting a Shadow Shiny Aerodactyl, so Cliff is definitely one that I'm going to be targeting, but Beldum and Carvana has a lot of implications as well when it comes to the Go Battle League. And Beldum, of course, is a very powerful Pokemon, at least it evolves into a very powerful one. Metagross is definitely going to be really strong as a Shadow Pokemon. So unlike the previous three sets of Shadow Pokemon that you could get, all three of these could potentially be a very useful Pokemon that's going to be Shadow. So that is something to look forward to with this new shakeup. But of course, this also means that Shiny Shadow Growlithe and Omanyte and Drowsy are no longer going to be available. So if you do not have any of these Pokemon, then it's tough luck. Now, along with these new shadow Pokemon, we're also going to be seeing a shakeup with the 12 kilometer egg pool. We're going to be seeing these Pokemon hatching from 12 kilometer eggs after this event, and that is going to be Quillfish, Larvitar, Corphish, Absol, Skorupi, Scraggy, Ponyard, Lullaby, and Dino. There really isn't too much of a difference other than the fact that they got rid of the Trubbish out of the egg pool, but of course they added two new trash Pokemon along with it. Three if you count Skorupi. So it's kind of unfortunate the egg pool has gotten a lot more convoluted, and the ones that people desperately want, it's going to be a lot more difficult to get those particular Pokemon. Quite honestly, I really feel like when it comes to 12 kilometer eggs, considering the effort it takes to actually hatch these eggs, they really should be eliminating some of the trash pulls out of these eggs and focusing more on Pokemon like Dino and Ponyard and Volibee and different Pokemon like that. I mean, I can't tell you how many 12 kilometer kilometer eggs I've hatched at this point, and I still do not have even one sandile. So yeah, that should tell you everything you need to know regarding 12 kilometer eggs. So unfortunately, we do not see any new positive changes to 12 kilometer eggs, but at least when it comes to the shadow Pokemon, there's a lot of really good ones out of this particular pool of shadow Pokemon. So yeah, that's at least something to look forward to. Now, very specific to this particular event, we're going to see a lot of nice little bonuses. First and foremost, you're going to have half egg hatching distance, which is one of those bonuses that I think gets underutilized. I think a lot of players tend to ignore this particular one, but I really think it's extremely useful right now, considering that 12 kilometer eggs are only going to be 6 kilometers to hatch if you're using regular incubators. But on top of that, some of the people who are trying to level up to level 46 will find that hatching 30 eggs with this bonus is going to be a cakewalk. So fully utilize this bonus when you can, especially because hatching eggs is also a really good way to stock up on Stardust as well as XL candies. Even though this may not necessarily seem like a very good bonus, it actually is one of the best bonuses in the game. Something else that's going to be exclusive with this event is an increased frequency of Team Go Rocket balloons. So if you are in need of Team Go Rocket battles but you're not able to travel, well, you should be able to complete any of your field research tasks or special research or even your level 44 requirements straight from home because you're going to be getting an increased frequency of Team Go Rocket balloons. More specifically, they are going to be spawning once every 2 hours as opposed to every 6 hours, so be on the lookout for that. And another thing that we're going to be getting with this event is a special timed research that's been kind of common with all the in-game events so far. We're going to be having a bunch of different rewards through a bunch of different tasks. Now, just like other timed research, it's not necessarily going to be a story special research. It's just going to be a bunch of additional tasks that's going to have a limited time. You're only going to be able to do this while the event is currently in play, so make sure you get it done as soon as possible. And then of course we're going to be getting a lot of special event specific spawns. We're going to see a lot of dark and poison types like we usually do with Team Go Rocket events. The event spawns that we're going to be seeing with this particular event include Zubat and Golbat, Grimer, Koffing, Ariados, Quillfish, Sneasel, Houndoom, Nuzleaf, Stunky, Skorupi, Venipede, and Scraggy. Of course, a lot of these event spawns are not necessarily that impactful, but considering that quite a lot of them can be shiny, it's always going to be really exciting. Now, I mentioned at the top of this video that there is a missed opportunity when it comes to this event, and it's in relation to whether or not you could TM away frustration on your shadow Pokemon. I've been saying this for a while now on my YouTube channel, but I really feel like this should be something that's bi-monthly or even monthly. The ability to TM away frustration is extremely crucial when it comes to PvP. Like if you're in the Go Battle League and you have a lot of good shadow Pokemon but they still have frustration, it's definitely going to gimp your ability to get the higher ranks. So I really feel like this should be something that is available to trainers at a more frequent pace. Because as of right now, it's extremely frustrating, no pun intended, to get frustration off of your shadow Pokemon. You have to wait a very long time and Niantic has not done a really good job communicating with it. And I really feel like every time they do some sort of Team Go Rocket event, that should be the time where you should be able to TM away frustration. I don't even think it has to be the full duration of this event, but at least for one day, you should be able to TM away frustration every month. But yeah, that's just my thoughts on it. Overall, I really do like this event, and I think there's a lot to look forward to. I just feel like that's one particular thing that's missing from this event, and I know a lot of players agree with that. Hopefully, Niantic is fully aware of what the community is thinking, and then in future events, they actually give us the ability to TM away frustration. That's really up to Niantic, and I really hope they pay attention to that. But in any case, yeah, that's everything going on with this event. I would love to know your thoughts down below. What are you going to be focusing on with this new Team Go Rocket event? I would definitely like to know. Let's have a great discussion, and if you ended up enjoying this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe if it's your first time here. I am Count Jinsula. Be safe, have fun, and I'll catch you all later.